Gratitude is my superpower. Hi, my name is Betsy, and this is Mr. T. I am only 7, but he is 70. You wouldn't know to look at him. He never seems to age. He slowly moves around the house and doesn't have a cage. One day, when I was playing with him, I suddenly felt quite sad. "What is the matter?" Mom said. "You are usually so glad." "It is Mr. T," I said to her. "I think there is something wrong. To carry that big house all day, he has to be so strong. Do you think it stops him from having fun like me? I have never seen him run or jump as happy as can be." "Oh, my dear, you must not worry. Mr. T is fine. Turtles have different needs in life. They are not like yours or mine. The nature of a turtle is harmless, quiet, and shy. They love to hide inside their shells when people pass them by. So Mr. T is very grateful for everything he has got, which means he doesn't worry about things he has not." "Let's play a game together," Mom said. "I call it gratitude. It will help you understand Mr. T. Are you in the mood?" Mom takes me to the garden and just behind the flowers, picking up a stone, she says, "This has superpowers. Every time you're upset, when things don't go as planned, you take out your gratitude stone and hold it in your hand. The stone will work its magic, and soon you will begin to see everything that's happening is how it's meant to be." No sooner had we gone inside, the sky began to rain. Tears began to fill my eyes. I wanted to go out again. Remembering my special stone, I squeezed with all my might. What could I be grateful for when rain was in my sight? But just then, I remembered, without it, plants won't grow, fish wouldn't live in the sea, and rivers wouldn't flow. "Thank you, sky, for raining. You are really rather clever. Now I know the job you do. You can rain whenever." Next morning, when it's time to wake, my body is filled with dread. Going to school is the last thing I want. I would rather stay home instead. Beneath my pillow is my stone. I squeeze it once again, remembering the friends I would see and my teacher, Mrs. Blaine. At school, I had forgotten. Today was sibling day. I don't have any siblings, so I didn't know what to say. My stone will have the answer, I thought. I will squeeze it and we will see. "Of course," I said. "I am grateful because I have Mr. T." At dinner time, it worked again. When Mom put down my plate, no yummy cake, but rice and veg, which I didn't appreciate. But then I remembered the children who aren't as lucky as me to have a healthy, warm meal cooked by their mommy. At bedtime, when I am not tired and want to play instead, I am grateful for my turtle pajamas and warm and cozy bed. But just then, I remember, I am not even carrying the stone. "Mom," I shout, "I did gratitude and I did it on my own." "Of course you did, my darling, because gratitude is in there. Upon my heart," she places her hand. With the other, she strokes my hair. So gratitude is in all of us, I said. And all we have to do is stop and think how thankful we are instead of feeling blue. Next day, during playtime, there is a new boy there with shiny braces on his teeth and curly light brown hair. Tears are falling down his face. He wished he had not moved, a decision made by his parents, and he had not approved. I tell him of the gratitude stone and ask if we can find something to be thankful for that he can bear in mind. He holds the stone and thinks a minute, a smile across his face. I am thankful for our new home. The garden has so much space. Now, every time I go out, I make sure to have with me at least one stone to pass on along with my story. The more we share about gratitude, the happier we will be. Will you share the story and help other children like me? I have started writing my gratitude notes, and I wish you all will start too. Did you like this book? Yes, I do. And pass on your gratitude to other children, just like I did. So take care, bye-bye. Happy Thanksgiving Day!